Let me give you a disclaimer right at the start of this podcast episode. Just visualization is not going to result into you unlocking success and abundance in your life. However, without visualization, it is going to be just as difficult, if not impossible, to unlock your success and abundance. So do not skip this episode just because just visualization is not going to help. I'll give you a very straightforward example of why visualization is so important. Pick up any Olympic winner. Pick up any sports person who has achieved success that you feel is phenomenal. Their coach has always trained them to visualize their performance on the D-Day a million times before they even touch the arena. So if this particular visualization technique has worked for every sports person worth their salt, why is it not going to work for you? Visualization is very powerful. And by the end of this episode, I am going to teach you or give you a way or give you enough reasons for you to start visualizing every aspect of your financial life and unlock and manifest your wealth that you deserve and desire. So get ready to visualize with Manifest with Paycheck to Profit. I'm Manish Ahuja, your favorite and India's only, first and only, money mindset and financial literacy coach who's doing everything in my capacity to help you manifest and create the life of your desires, your dreams, and manifest everything that you could want for your life with one episode of this podcast at a time. You can start being mindful about visualization with small things. What happens with people who get stuck with law of attraction is that they are trying to look for things which is probably on a level 9 or level 10 of their life, wherever they are. I'm telling you, don't visualize level 9 or level 10 at the moment. Forget about level 5. I'm telling you, start getting acclimatized. When you go hiking, you are never taken directly to the summit. You're always taken to a base camp. You are told to stay at the base camp for a day, two, three, depending on the kind of summit that you're going for. That entire process is called acclimatization. I want you to acclimatize yourself to the whole concept of visualization and manifestation. Don't try to unlock a big house for yourself or a big car for yourself right on day one. Don't. I'm telling you, try to start very, very, very small and fundamental. A new shoe, a new outfit, an invitation to a particular gathering or a party or a mastermind that you've been wanting to be a part of. Just try to see things in your life happening with regards to things that you are already confident of being able to achieve and being able to accept entirely as your own. Today, you probably can't imagine owning a house that's 10,000 square feet, a big home with a great garden, sea view or a mountain view. Maybe that's not possible for you today. But getting a new shoe is. So what if it's probably 20, 30, 40% of your monthly salary? A new bag. So what if it is worth 3 months of your salary? It's perfectly okay. It's still a step that you can take. So start visualizing with something that is small and believable. Second, the moment you get an opportunity in your life, start upgrading your life with small things which make you happy. Now, I don't want you to find happiness in materialistic things, but we are living humans. So when we get something new, it does bring a sense of joy and happiness. Whenever you are sensing that happiness, hold on to that moment for a little longer. Feel that happiness, because I'll tell you why this is so important. Experience that happiness over and over again multiple times in your life. But next time, whenever you are happy, hold on to that sense of happiness for 2 more seconds. Understand how you feel on the inside. The reason why I want you to do that is because when you get used to understanding that feeling of happiness, it becomes very easy for you to tap into that energy whenever you want to. And the more time and effort you invest towards understanding law of attraction, you'll understand it's all about unlocking energies. So when you experience that energy, and when you start focusing on that energy, it becomes easier for you to tap into that energy again and again. It will start with a small thing, then it will become a little bigger thing, then it will be, you'll get used to this. So probably understand this. What is 2 plus 2? The moment I finished that question, the answer came to your mind. What is 2 into 20? Again, maybe it took you 1 second, but it was easy for you to unlock that answer because you've gotten used to this. How about what is 17 into 13? Now, if you're somebody who's practiced enough, that answer was easy for you. What about 33 into 43? The more you practice on the small things, the easier it becomes for you to unlock the bigger things. So similarly with this, try to sense what is possible, upgrade your life, and once you've started upgrading your life, capture that emotion and feel it for 2, 3, 4, 5 more seconds. The third thing that you can do to learn how to unlock abundance and visualize everything is become somebody who contributes on a regular basis. It's always possible to find people who are not as fortunate as you, who do not have the kind of resources that you have. Make it a habit to contribute to people who are less fortunate than you on a regular basis. The way I told you to hold on to your happiness, it's being somebody, becoming a person who is abundant enough or who believes in abundance enough that they share what they have, a part of what they have, is a very important sense of feeling abundance. And once you understand the joy of giving, you will want to expand on it. You'll start with, let's say, $10, then you'll move to $15, you'll go to $20, you'll go to $30, $50, $100. Who knows, tomorrow, sometime in the future, you will be contributing more than your annual salary or your annual paycheck today. It's all about expanding your relationship with money, becoming more abundant, becoming more joyous with regards to how you spend your money, how you earn your money, how you contribute towards a better society. That's very important. One way of giving is also sharing knowledge. And for that, let me invite you to my two ways of how I share knowledge with my community. In the description of this podcast episode, you will find links to become a part of the Profit Clan. Now, Profit Clan is email newsletters that I send to people of my community. So make sure that you're a part of the Profit Clan. And if you prefer to get all the updates on WhatsApp, you'll also find a link to get all these updates on WhatsApp as your choice of preference. Both the options are free. I share a lot of knowledge with my community participants, new videos that are getting released, newsletters, reels and other short form videos which have, you know, gotten a lot of views. I just share everything that I think can help and add value to my community. So make sure that you're a part of my Profit Clan and the WhatsApp updates that you will find in the description below. The fourth thing, which is the easiest thing to do and my most favorite way to visualize abundance and visualize success, is bless people who have more than you. Bless people who are achieving things that you've wanted for yourself. Bless people who are unlocking the kind of things that you are wanting to manifest for yourself. Somebody is getting a car that you've always wanted to drive, bless them. Somebody is moving into a new house, bless them. Somebody is taking a vacation to a place that you've always wanted to go to, bless them. It's all about being abundant. It's all about feeling happiness, and it's all about being okay with universe gifting you or universe granting your desire at the right time. But in the process, when you are finding somebody else who is achieving what you always wanted, when you find happiness in other people's happiness, you start expanding your own happiness. You expand your energy field. And that energy field is actually going to be the reason why you unlock every desire of your life. I am telling you, this may seem very meta or this may seem very cuckoo to somebody, but this is what it is. Let me also recommend you one particular video, which is my particular favorite, or my one episode from this podcast, which is my absolute favorite, is how improving your self-worth is going to help you attract more money. You'll find the link to that episode again in the description. So do not forget to listen to that episode. Even if you've listened to that episode earlier or seen that episode earlier, make sure that you watch it again. It's absolutely one of the deepest episodes that I've gone into. So please make sure that you watch that episode or listen to that episode. The fifth and the last thing that I would like you to do is to reduce the amount of time you spend around people who are either negative in nature or in the way they communicate, or they are always comparing people. They are spending a lot of time gossiping. Be around people who help you elevate your energy and not drain the energy out of you. This is again very important. In almost every episode, I talk about the power of spending time around the right set of people. And again, in this episode, I'm going to repeat it because it is that important. Let me consolidate again and tell you what I've spoken about. Start being mindful about what's possible for you. Make believable goals. Try to unlock those believable goals whenever you get an opportunity, and stick with that emotion for a few more seconds. Feel that emotion, register that emotion, record that emotion on the inside. Contribute on a regular basis. Bless people who have more than you, and reduce the amount of time that you spend around people who are negative by nature or by mindset. These five simple ways are going to help you visualize and learn how to attract your success and abundance, unlock your success and abundance. If you have any questions about whatever I've just shared with you today, make sure that you connect with me on social media. I'm very easy to reach out to on social media. Ask me a question. I'll answer them as soon as possible, or maybe even make an episode on one of the questions that you ask me. If you have been listening to this episode for all this while, please take a few more minutes and leave a 5-star review. It takes just a couple of minutes, but every review or every 5 stars that this podcast gets enables this episode to reach out to hundreds and thousands of more people, and you will become a catalyst to them realizing ways to manifest their desires. So please do that. If you've really liked this episode and found value, and you would like to share this value with others on social media, take a screenshot of this particular podcast, share it on social media. Do not forget to tag Pay2Pro and Mr. Emojical. That's my personal handle. And I'll be happy to share your shout out with my community. Thank you so much for giving me your time. Thank you so much for listening to this episode till the end. I'll now see you next Monday with a new episode of Manifest with Paycheck to Profit. I'm Manish Ahuja, your favorite and India's first money mindset and financial literacy coach. I'll see you in the next episode. Until then, keep going, keep growing. Thank you so much.